Well, good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
And especially good morning. Anyone here for the first time? Anyone here as a visitor? And good morning to our girls' brigade. And I've said I'll forgive them if any of them fall asleep during the service. They've had what they called a sleepover, but I understand not much sleep happened. So they may be yawning or dozing off during the service, but that's okay, as long as you had a great time. It's great to be together to worship God. We know that God is present with us by His Spirit. And so we gather in the name of Jesus to worship God with all that's in us, to give our heart, mind, soul, and strength to the one who is worthy of all that we can bring. Come, now is the time to worship. We sing, it's number 24 in the books, and the words will appear on the screen. Come, now is the time. For our opening prayers this morning, we're going to be doing some active prayers, not too active, but all I'm going to ask you to do is to point. We've done this before. And first, we're going to point upwards. Okay. And think about God. And of course, God doesn't live on the ceiling or in a cloud, but we think of God as higher than us. And so we point up as we pray. God, you are higher and more amazing, more awesome than we can imagine. You have created all things, the beauty that we see in the world around us and the beauty that we see in each other. We are your people and we worship you. Amen. And next we point to ourselves as we pray, loving God. We thank you that even though you are higher than us, you choose to show your love to each one of us, even though sometimes we feel unworthy. You know us completely, and there is nothing that we can hide from you. So we offer our thanks for the good things, and we say that we're sorry for our mistakes and our selfish choices, knowing that you will forgive us. And we offer to you our strengths, our struggles, our worries, our hurts, asking for your renewing and healing, your comfort and strength. Amen. And now we point to each other. God, our Father and our Mother, we thank you that we are part of your family and that in Jesus you join us together with our sisters and our brothers and call us to learn to follow Christ together and to serve you in the world. We ask that you would be at work among us today by your Holy Spirit. Amen. And finally, we point outwards through the doors and the windows to the communities in which we live. Transforming God, we ask that during this time of worship, you would strengthen us, challenge us, help us to grow in grace that we may then continue to worship you by the way we live our lives, and that others may see something of your love and grace in us. Amen. Encourage one another. So the Girls Brigade have been thinking about Daniel, about bravery and courage. And today we're going to be thinking about what helps us to be brave and courageous. We're thinking about encouragement. And I'm going to be telling you about one other example from the Bible. But firstly, an example from one of the best films ever. I'm sure you know that's Paddington 2, by the way. Paddington 2, one of the best films ever. And I think that Paddington is a great example of being an encourager. And even when Paddington ends up in prison for a crime he didn't commit, he provides encouragement to the most feared man in there, Knuckles McGinty. So I hope you enjoy this.
Forget the medic. Better send a priest.
You listen to me, you little maggot.
Listening?
Nobody criticizes my food.
Right.
Nobody squirts condiments on my apron.
Got it.
And nobody bonks me on the head with a baguette.
No bonking.
I'll overhaul the menu, all right.
Really?
Dish of the day?
Yes.
Bear pie.
Well, I don't like it!
What is this?
It's a marmalade sandwich.
Marmalade?
My Aunt Lucy taught me to make them.
You mean you can make this?
Well, yes.
Stand aside.
Now, Mr. McGinty, I may look like a hardened criminal to you, but I really am innocent. And if you're not going to help me clear my name, you could at least help me make this marmalade.
All right, I'll help.
Thank you.
Not going to be much use to you, though. These aren't exactly made for cooking.
Oh, I don't know. Looks to me like you've got yourself a fine pair of orange squeezers.
Orange squeezers?
Good. No. Better. Tomato. Lovely. Yes. Spot on. Now, we have to be very careful with knives. Aunt Lucy said that sensible bears... Where on earth did you learn to use a knife like that?
You don't want to know.
Well, it's jolly good. Now? Now. Right, it's time for the sugar. That's what turns the juice into marmalade.
Much?
Oh, a lot. Same again. Ah. A squeeze of lemon. A pinch of cinnamon. And just a bit more sugar.
Well, is it good?
Oh, it's too soon to tell. We'll only really know once it's set. Are you all right, Knuckles?
Yes.
Well, why don't you come and join the others?
Don't want to.
Are you scared what they might think?
No.
What do they think? Did they like it? Did they say anything? What did they say?
Well...
They hated it! I knew it! My father always thought it amounted to nothing, and he was right!
Knuckles! Knuckles!
What?
Come and look.
Tingle in my tum-tum.
I think that's called pride, Knuckles.
Well, I don't like it.
this little proverb you would understand. You will lend your brothers a helping hand.
Oh, nice.
If this
large,
little
though.
Proverb you will understand. You will lend your brothers a helping
Thank
hand.
You, Phipps.
Whether you are white, green, blue,
there
or brown.
Go, Paddington. Oh,
6 feet of wood.
I want those penny pours now.
Whether you agree or you should disagree, you cannot disregard the truth of this philosophy. Singing life would be easier, time would be breezier if you love your neighbor.
Excuse me, Professor. What would Aunt Lucy say?
Why's use kite for?
Well, then.
Now, even though on the surface Knuckles McGinty seems like a real hard nut, inside he's actually scared and insecure. Scared of what others may think. Scared that his dad was right when he said he'd never amount to anything. Scared to try cooking anything different. But with Paddington's encouragement, he discovers that he's actually a pretty good chef. We all need encouragement in our lives. And the Bible speaks a lot about encouragement. The word encourage means to give someone courage, to help someone to overcome their fears and to help them to see that they really do have what it takes to do that thing that seems scary at first, perhaps something in serving God. In the Bible, we read about Saul of Tarsus, who later became Paul the Apostle, the one who founded so many churches on his missionary journeys. But before, Paul was a bit of a hard nut. In fact, he was a bit of a nasty character, spending his time persecuting the Christians of the early church. But then Jesus appears to him in a vision of blinding light on the road to Damascus, and he becomes a follower of Jesus and starts to preach. But his first attempt at serving Jesus as a preacher ends up as a bit of a disaster. He preaches in such an argumentative way that the people want to kill him rather than follow Jesus as disciples. And the other Christians struggle to accept that he really has changed and seem to think that Saul is going to be more of a liability than a help in the mission of the early church. So they send him back to his hometown of Tarsus. And he's probably feeling a bit of a failure at this point, feeling afraid to ever try preaching ever again. But a few years later, a man called Joseph of Cyprus was part of a church that was growing fast in Antioch. And he decided that Saul would be the perfect person to help him with that work. So he went to Tarsus to find Saul and encouraged him and helped him to try again with his preaching and church leadership. And because of that encouragement, Saul was able to face his fears and try again and to use and develop those amazing gifts that God had given him to help the church to grow. And so Saul of Tarsus became Paul, the amazing apostle. And because Joseph of Cyprus was so amazing at encouraging not just Saul, but all kinds of other people, they gave him the nickname Barnabas, which means son of encouragement. And after experiencing the power of encouragement, Paul often mentions the importance of encouragement in the letters that he sends to the churches he founded. He even says that some people have a special gift for encouragement. Now, without Barnabas, the encourager, the early church would never have grown the way that it did. A challenge for us today. Who can you be an encourager to in the coming days? encouragers are really important in the life of the church. Now, you might be aware that we currently have a number of roles to fill in the life of St. Andrew's Church. And we're focusing especially at the moment on the need for people to be part of our finance team. But there are other needs too. And you may have read the letter in the latest Tidings magazine and thought, I wonder if I might be called to do that, but it sounds a bit scary. Well, I want to really encourage you to think and to pray about that seriously, because the church cannot function without those roles being filled. But also, it may be that there are folks that you know who would be great in some roles in the church, but they're a bit afraid. They don't yet believe that they have what it takes. But your encouragement could make all the difference. Like Paddington to Knuckles McGinty, like Barnabas to Saul of Tarsus. May we be a community of encouragers, helping one another along the sometimes scary journey of following Jesus, marching together in the light and the love and the power of God. Let's sing together our next hymn. We are marching in the light of God. It's number 483 in the books, and the words will also appear on the screen. We're going to spend some time in prayer now. And during our prayers, we're going to use some actions to help us to think about what we're praying for. I don't know if you'd like to put your hands in front of you like that and imagine that you're holding something that's really heavy. So it's really, really heavy what you're holding in your hands. And then imagine that that heavy thing that you're holding in your hands actually represents the things that might feel heavy in our lives, that heavy weight represents, the things that we're worried about, the things that we're afraid about, both for ourselves, for those that we love, for those in our community, and for our world. And so in our prayers, we're offering these things into God's hands. And so as you hold your hands out and think what those things are for you? What are the things that you are worried about for yourself, for those you love, and for the world around us? And then as we remember that the Bible encourages us to cast our burdens, our heavy weights, onto Jesus, because he cares for us. So then just imagine, and you might want to do an action with your hands, handing over that heavy weight and placing it into somebody else's hands, into the hands of Jesus. Loving Lord Jesus, we offer to you our prayers. And we offer to you those things that seem heavy to us at the moment. Our worries, our fears, our cares. Especially those things for the coming week that are going to be difficult for us. And we offer to you those things that we're worried about in the world around us. For people who we've never met, and yet we know who are enduring unimaginable things. And we pray for them, and we pray for peace, and we pray for healing, and we pray for harmony. We pray for justice, and we pray that you would give us the strength to serve you, the courage that we need, and that you would help us to encourage one another on the journey of following you together. We ask all these prayers in Jesus' name. Amen. So as we seek to follow Jesus in the coming days, whatever that means for us, whether that might take us through scary things and joyful things, we pray that we will know that our Lord is with us through it all. We sing together number 477 in the books, the words on the screen, "Teach me to dance to the beat of your heart." And so now may the blessing of God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be upon us, remain with us this day and always. And may we be empowered by the Holy Spirit to be a blessing to those we meet. Amen.